Hello and good morning to our webinar. The title today is Speed is of the Essence. How to transform your new project managers into star performers in just 3 months. This is part of a series of webinars exploring best practices in project management and service delivery based on Hydra's experience in delivering solutions to our customers using our unique blend of digital technology and services. We'll also look in particular at case studies from one of our customers. So what are we going to see today? We're going to talk about how important is the onboarding process and structure to make sure that new project managers can come online and be productive members of the team as quickly as possible. The challenges of onboarding processes and how to transform onboarding to make sure that new PMs can become star performers in just 3 months. Onboarding, unfortunately, is too often seen as a jump into the pool and then sink or swim kind of proposition. We take people who have maybe good experience in project management, certified, but have no specific knowledge of the way we do things in our organization, and we pretend that they suddenly jump into the pool and start swimming like Olympic level swimmer. The reality is that onboarding needs to be a process, a well-controlled, documented, and a well-thought-out process. It's a process where new employees acquire the skills, the knowledge, the behavior, even the way of speaking, the language, that they require to become effective contributor to our organization. It's a process of knowledge transfer in which the experience of existing employees is shared, distributed to new employees. Unfortunately, not many organizations are really effective at this process of transferring knowledge. Often the greatest challenge for many organizations is a lack of a formalized and well-planned knowledge transfer approach. This is obviously a shame because many research show that the effective utilization of lessons learned across the organization to improve and standardize the best practices, the way we do things, can have a huge impact on our bottom line. Gross margins can go up to almost 10 percentage points, which is a huge number. Just using the knowledge we already have within the organization and making sure it's used effectively throughout. If we talk about onboarding and the process, I think there are four key components that we want to look at. Knowledge, the content of what we want to transfer, the practice of putting this knowledge into use in a real-life environment, the structure and the direction, what we want to achieve essentially in terms of onboarding, what are our priorities. And finally, last but not least, the mentor role, the guidance that have to support this process and make sure it is effectively delivered to the new, in this case, project managers. When we have new project managers, we often hire people who have skills in project management. They are certified, they have been probably successful in their previous career, but obviously they don't have any specific knowledge about what we do. Often they have their own ideas, but they've never had an experience in doing exactly what we do. So how can we take these new people, these project managers gone wild, and tame them and bring them within the fold of our organization, of the way we do things? First of all, the first component of onboarding, the knowledge. Knowledge can be broadly divided into two categories. What we call formal knowledge, typically including things like a methodology, how to do things, a common language, metrics on how to measure things, expectation, benchmarks of performance, standards, all things that are often well documented, sometimes part of a formal training sessions or days, and they are communicated in a very organized way. Unfortunately, only part of knowledge is formal. A lot of it is what we call informal knowledge, things that are not really documented, often that are very difficult to document, things that often resides in the heads of the best practitioner, the shortcuts, the little things that are not written anywhere but are the keys of delivering something effectively. All this body of knowledge is more often than not dispersed, as I said, probably in the heads of the people who do things, is not there is no formal structure of gathering and then distributing this knowledge. And obviously, all this loses a great deal of data or information that could be really useful to the newcomers to be effective. The second component of onboarding is the practice of taking this knowledge and putting it into use in a real-life situation. So this is often achieved through a shadowing process. New project managers start working on some projects with existing project managers, and they learn on the job. Obviously, as soon as possible, we want them to move out of the shadowing and be main leader of the projects themselves. But there is always a balance to be found between the pressure of obviously delivering, the pressure of having these people as soon as possible being productive, and the risk of taking the little wheelies of the bike too early and achieving, you know, problems and critical issues in the delivery of projects. The third component of onboarding is the structure and the direction that we as an organization want to give the onboarding and knowledge transfer process. Unless I know where I want to go, I will never get there. There are a lot of destinations, all valid, but you have to take different roads to get there. So as an organization, we need to be very clear about what is the key objective that we want to achieve. Do we want project managers who are fast? Do we want project managers who are who minimize the risk at any cost? Do we want project managers that are particularly looking at budgets? All these things are valid. There is not right and wrong answer. It's simply what is our priorities, what is more important, and how do we measure these priorities? What are KPI that we want to measure, and the end game that we want to achieve? All this gives a structure of our knowledge transfer process, because based on the objective we want to achieve, then all our process should be aligned towards steering the project managers, the new project managers, into the acquisition of the skills, moving them towards that specific objectives. Last but not least, the mentor role. This is not necessarily a person, could be a structure, could be the PMO office. It's really about applying the structure and the knowledge and making sure that it's being absorbed in the correct way. It's a supervision role. It's a role about the required ability to spot problems and provide solution, and in general steer the new entries, the new project managers, in the right direction, helping them absorb, seeing at what level they are, and judging, we're talking about taking the wheelie off the bike before, what the right moment to really move them into a situation where they can take care of themselves and start delivering projects without supervision, I mean, without the supervision of a senior project manager. So let's look at this in real life case studies based on our own experience with one of our customers. Polycom, you probably know Polycom, is a US but now global technology manufacturer with specific, obviously, specifically in the network and telecommunication industry. It's a company that was originally a hardware manufacturer, but is moving more and more into a turnkey solution providers. Polycom is not just selling network boxes, but is selling a turnkey solution so that the customers are buying a service more than just simply screens or telecommunication networks equipment. They just want Polycom to provide everything. Something is broken, it's Polycom's duty to fix it. And obviously, this movement from being simply a hardware manufacturer to be more a service-oriented company has brought their own set of challenges for Polycom. Polycom has selected Hydra, in particular, for the deployment of their top-end telepresence solution. These are highly complex technology solutions involving more than 6 tons of equipment and often are projects that span multiple geographies, countries, even continents at a time. Polycom needed a partner to help them to really look at increasing efficiency of their delivery, standardizing the quality of their engagement with their customers, and also leveraging Polycom knew what the best way to implement their, obviously, their own products were, they had experience. They just wanted to make sure that these experiences, these best practices, were adopted by all the teams in all the geographies in the same time, in the same way. In particular, the challenge from Polycom point of view is that one of their key metrics for the project manager performance, and obviously we talked about the importance of metrics and knowing where your objective is before, one of the key metrics was what they call revenue recognition, meaning the successful completion of a site, because when a site is ready to start being connected to the network and start transmitting, then that's where Polycom can finally, you know, build the customers and get revenues from that activity. So the key metrics for a project manager was time to deliver a site, time to completion. A good problem that Polycom had and still has is that their business is going very well. So obviously they have a pressure to reduce the backlog because the customers want to be, after obviously buying their services and their hardware, they want to be online as soon as possible. So Polycom is scaling up their project delivery team with new project managers, but obviously how quickly we can bring these new project managers online, but at the same time minimizing the risks, because obviously if something goes wrong in a project, the customer is not satisfied and it will take additional resources and delay in solving these projects, these challenges. So with Hydra, Polycom looked at two parts of the solution. The first one was obviously increasing the efficiency of existing teams, taking the people that were already within the Polycom service delivery team and help them be more efficient. How? Essentially documenting this knowledge and best practices, applying these best practices across the team, using effectively using better metrics and data to measure the important deliverables, to focus on the things where maybe where delays occurred more often, the use of effective tools for collaboration, especially when we are talking about teams that work across many geographies. It's sometimes not easy to synchronize their work and supervise all that they're doing across a large space. All these things together helped increase the efficiency of existing team. And then the second part of the solution was faster, better onboarding, getting new people on board, but making sure they were, as soon as possible, able to power up and deliver to the level that Polycom was expecting. So it was about a structured process of knowledge transfer, both formal knowledge and informal knowledge transfer, making sure that this knowledge that was transferred was only the best practices. Too often, training includes a lot of things that are not really necessary, and they're cluttering, and they're just confusing, or sometimes they're even negative habits that you don't want your new project managers to pick up. It was important to define clear directions and objectives, including the timeline, expectations, the metrics that Olicom needed to measure the readiness of the PM to take on the RACV role, and the increased ability for the PMO group, for the service control group, to overview and mentor with precision, following exact schedule, exact KPIs, to essentially power up our PMs and transform them into Super Mario. How do they do this? They use Hydra and our unique technology and services, what we call blueprints. Blueprints are a unique way of documenting and capturing knowledge. What we often think about templates are just the tip of the iceberg of what is needed to deliver a project. Templates might contain a Gantt chart, some document templates, maybe a checklist of things to do, a WBS structure, but that's just a very superficial and monodimensional way of looking at the projects. What really makes a difference, the biggest part of the iceberg, is underneath the water. It's all those little things that build together create a successful service delivery. For instance, the skills that are needed for a particular task, the experience, the roles, the processes, the checklists and checkpoints within the projects, a particular type of reports and maybe dashboards that are appropriate to one type of service but maybe not to others. So in a certain situation we need to set a focus on certain information and not others. The structure of your deliverables, the risks and issues that are typical in a certain type of projects, so that the new project manager already has knows where to focus to avoid or minimize these risks. All the budgeting and financial part, cost, rates, efficiency, expected value delivered at any given time, and in general the best practice. All these things are captured into a blueprint and are not in the templates. And without this, all these items, some of them belong to the formal knowledge group that we talked about, but a lot of it belong to the informal knowledge group that we talked about before, and they're difficult to capture unless you have our unique solution and technology. So a blueprint then drives all the projects of a certain type that are delivered. A new project manager can just take the blueprint. The blueprint is the recipe, the music sheet, they're going to help them play the music. So the project manager can focus on problem solving, on looking after the customer, on maybe adapting the blueprint to a certain extent to the specific situation. The customer might have very unique requirements that need to be taken care of. So the project manager can focus on these things, on the dynamic aspects of the management of a project and not on developing the knowledge, because the knowledge is already contained down to the last detail into the blueprint. And then even at the execution level, the people who are doing the tasks on the ground might not be the project manager, might be an engineer, might be a consultant, might even be a person from a customer, somebody who's involved in our projects from a customer point of view, or an external contractors. All this will have all the information they need, from the checklist to the financial, to the output documents, to a guide or a video on how to do certain things that will drive the best practices. This will minimize the risk for the project managers of something skipping outside of their own control, and obviously will make the adoption of best practices for new project managers a lot faster. So what was the result of all this activity and performance? Essentially, with Polycom, we started by identifying the top performers. In every organization, you have your superheroes. You know who they are. They are the people that, whenever you have a big problem, you send them to solve it. You know they're going to deliver on time and budget. They've done it over and over and over again many times, and you know you can rely on them. They are the consistently top performers of your team. How do they do it? They're probably good at what they do, certainly, but also based on their experience, they have a lot of knowledge They have a lot of knowledge about how the best way to do things, what corners you can cut safely if you have to rush things through, or which are not to be cut because they're too dangerous. They know all these little nuances and informal knowledge that you really need to move from normal to super delivery. So what we did, we identified them together with Polycom, we sat with them, and we helped download their knowledge into the blueprint. So in a few days, the top PMs basically downloaded what was in their brain into the blueprint, creating the structure, the basic information to drive in the best possible way the type of projects. Then the new PMs, the new project manager, were hired by Polycom. These were experienced project managers. They were not fresh out of schools, obviously, certified, but with zero knowledge of the specific solution that Polycom was providing. They knew about project management, so they had the techniques, but they didn't know how to apply these techniques into the environment of Polycom. They didn't know anything about Polycom technology. So using the blueprint, these new project managers became top performers, not only standard, but top performers in 3 months. Before this exercise, the benchmark for Polycom was 18 months. It took a year and a half for the new project managers to reach a level of proficiency of delivery that was deemed acceptable to Polycom in terms of KPI, in terms of time to delivery. Using Hydra, using our blueprints, they were top performers in just 3 months. Not average, top performers of the teams. This was obviously an enormous result in terms of both the efficiency of these new project managers, but also the efficiency of the organization on taking new people on board and making sure they were following the best practices. Obviously, the success was such that this was done in the group, the team working on European, EMEA, Middle East and Africa area. Now Polycom is exporting these practices to the rest of their geographies. So this is a summary Hydra success story. It's the digital technology plus the services powered by Hydra and your organization know-how. Because in the end, nobody better than your organization knows the best way to do things for your products, for your services. Your organization has accumulated experience in years on how was the best thing, the best way to do things. But all these information are often lost, or maybe you have your experience just walking out of the door when an experienced or consultant moves to another job or retires. All these things get lost. But together with the Hydra solutions, then you can achieve both reducing the risk, reducing your margin erosion, increasing your customer satisfaction and protecting your market reputation, and increase the competitive advantage in terms of delivery, both of your existing teams, increasing efficiency, but speeding up, obviously, the scaling up of the new resources you are hiring. We all know that one of the main challenges of businesses that are scaling up is to finding good people, obviously, but then making these good people productive as soon as possible to the level we expect. So the sooner we can do that, obviously, the lower our costs and the higher quality we can deliver to our own customers, resulting, obviously, in more business, happier customers. So just in summary, what we talked about today, we talked about how onboarding new resources efficiently, fast, is the key to growing business capabilities. You cannot grow your business unless you're able to bring on board good people and putting them to work as soon as possible. But to do that, you need a strong and documented knowledge base, and we're talking about informal knowledge as well as formal knowledge, and also the ability to take this knowledge and transfer it effectively to the new people. You need a strong process and a system to support this process. Otherwise, you're sort of treading water. You're just sitting people in a room for a couple of days of training, and then you send them in the whole wide world, but they would not be prepared. We also seen that there is no reason why a process that usually maybe takes 1 year, 1 year and a half, cannot be reduced to just a few months, just 3 months, to achieve top performance from the new project managers. So these are results that can be achieved by applying your knowledge, a little bit of help from our side, our services and our technology, obviously, but they are there for the taking. Now, we are going to email to all the participants of this webinar our infographic containing the information about what we talked about today. We'll also send you a link to some more videos and other infographics which contain a lot of interesting information. If you are interested in project management, service delivery, I advise you to check it out because you'll find a lot of interesting information, including, by the way, the video of a video from Polycom talking about some of the things we talked about today. You can obviously contact us through our website, that is our email, if you want to ask specific questions and or you want a personal demo. If there is some questions now, I will just, let's see if we have some questions. We have one question. The question is, how long does it take for the knowledge transfer from top performing PMs? Essentially, the answer is it depends, because obviously it depends on the complexity of the services you are delivering, but it is not a very long process, mostly because, again, based on our experience and experience with our customers, the trick is not doing the perfect blueprint, the perfect knowledge transfer from day one. It's a lot better to get something up and running quickly, see how it works, improve it. We believe in continuous improvement. Nothing is ever perfect. So it's much better to have something out there pretty quickly, 2-3 days, a week, working together, you create a blueprint. Then you start running projects based on this blueprint, and by running projects you learn that some things are probably can improve, some things are not correct, some others are correct. You gather data, and this leads to improving this. The same thing with the training. You start, you do it, you see the results, you're probably in the process of doing it, you learn new things. So rather go, I would rather go out and do it and collect information rather than create a ponderous process of gathering information and sitting down for months and months to arrive at the perfect blueprint, which will never be perfect anyway, because it's the world is constantly evolving, we live in dynamic situations, things change, we have to be ready to change with them. Other question, can Hydra help to monitor if the new project managers are complying with best practices? Yes, we do. One of our key part of our technologies and the services is using the blueprints, using the information on the blueprints that contains things like performance expectation, for instance, in terms of efforts, costs, time, and notice and help use the system to monitor variation against expectation. And this variation triggers a red flag so that very few people can monitor a lot of processes at the same time using a very clever process of alerts. And again, variation might not be necessarily a bad thing. We might learn new things. Maybe a project manager has some good ideas about a different way of doing things. The most important thing is about visibility, audit, and compliance. So for the project management office, for our support team to know what's going on and be able to monitor if things are deviating, investigate. There is a perfectly good reason maybe, or maybe not. The important thing is that knowing what's going on and having the capability to drill in the process and see exactly where the problem is happening, and then obviously address it. Okay, I think this concludes our session for us today. Thank you very much for attending, and we hope to see you soon at our future webinars. You'll receive invitation. If you check our website regularly, you'll see the schedule of our future webinars.